Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Evernote series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about shortcuts, or rather keyboard shortcuts, because those amazingly hard-working people over at Evernote headquarters have been busying away making sure that we have all our keyboard shortcuts. Now, the truth is, we don't have my beloved Command J, but we do have a way now of creating the same effect using search and the keyboard Command J, because now many of the keyboard shortcuts that make Evernote super, super fast have become editable. Anyway, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Evernote, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my Evernote now and I will show you what you can now do with the keyboard shortcuts. Okay, so here we go. Finally, we are able to use keyboard shortcuts, or we can customize our keyboard shortcuts now. So what you need to do in order to actually customize the keyboard shortcuts is open up the keyboard shortcuts. So I hear you wondering, where do I find my keyboard shortcuts? Now, for some strange reason, and I keep looking at this, Evernote have not added anything to our preferences yet. We can check spelling while typing, or we can turn that off, and that's really about it when it comes to preferences. Hopefully they will come back sooner rather than later. However, before we do that, what we can do is, if you want to actually go in and remove and start changing your keyboard shortcuts, what you need to do is you're going to help and you'll see keyboard shortcuts, or you can use the keyboard shortcut on a Mac. It's Command/. Well, let's just click on that and they come in at the side. Now, one of the things is you can actually use search to find a specific keyboard shortcut, although I don't know my keyboard shortcut, so I'm struggling there. But one of the things that I really like about this is this one here, the new note window. Now, this is too long for me to memory. I'm not going to have memory. But in the old Evernote, I used a keyboard shortcut to pull up the Evernote little quick add, which was, for me, it was Shift Command E. E represents Evernote. I have Shift Command D for drafts, and I have Shift Command T for Todoist. So, you know, for when I want to actually, Shift Command A, I should say, for Todoist. So what you can do now is you can go in here and you can click on the three dots at the side right there. So click on that and it says edit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to change this to my original one, which was Shift Command E, and now that's set. So now what I can do is if I just minimize this window, what I really like about this is if I'm on a call, I can do Shift Command E and bang, I get a new note right there and I can start typing into the note. That's super, super fast and I love that. So that's one way that you can do that, and that's why I really like that. Let's get this back. The other one that you can do is open Evernote Helper. Now, this is an interesting one. So what I'm going to do is I don't use this one. I'm going to edit it because I'm going to go Shift Command. Let's just do Shift Command R because I'm not going to use this, but I've just set that one up. So when I do that, let's minimize that again. What I can do is Shift Command R, and that brings up the quick note. Now, the thing about the quick note is there's not a lot I can do inside of this window. I suppose I can actually create a quick note, but I prefer to actually create the original note. It's less clicking because once I've created it, I can then convert to note and it sends. But that's one way you can do that as well. So I'm just go back there. Now let's just say that that isn't something that I want to use. So I'm going to put that restore the default keyboard shortcut. And this is something that's really good. So I'm going to restore the keyboard shortcut. There you go. It's restored. Now, the other one that I really wanted to show you was this, search in Evernote. Now, right now, it's Control Command E, which doesn't make any sense to me for search. And if those of you who followed this channel for a while, you know that when I was searching in Evernote, I like to use Command J. Now, that may come back in the future. It's not quite the same as Command J, but for now, that's the best I can do. So I'm going to change that to Command J. that gives me the keyboard shortcut that I want. Now you can go down here and you can do all sorts of things. There's a lot more coming in. As you can see, there's a load of new keyboard shortcuts. Now I don't usually go that far. I'm looking at quick entry, start typing. But for some of you, maybe you are using a lot of these and it's worth going through and having a look to see what you may want to do. The other one, by the way, that I do like to use is navigation. So I can, you can go to home, which is, I've got to look down there. This is option command one, open notes, option command two. These are on Mac. When you're using Windows, if you open up the keyboard shortcuts, they will be different. So just keep keep an eye on that. But what I do is I've got within Evernote, I've got like command one for inbox, and you can go to your various. So here, if you look at this open shortcut, so command and then 1 to 9. So inbox for me is number one. And then whatever I've got this week, number two. So I do use these ones quite a lot as well. Now, these ones you can't edit, as you notice down here. There's no three dots. The only ones that you can are the global shortcuts up here. These are the only ones that you can edit. So let's go back to my searching in Evernote. So at the moment, what it was before is you go up here to the search bar and you click on that and boom. But now that I've changed it, if I go Command J, that opens up and I can start typing straight away to get to whatever notes I want. It's not quite the same as the original Command J, but perhaps that's going to come, or they do promise that's coming back soon, and that would be really nice. So there you go. Now you have the ability to edit your keyboard shortcuts. And to do that now, to find the edit function, you just go into help up at the top there, and then you go down to the keyboard shortcuts, open that, and now you've got them right here and you can play around with them. Seriously, guys, keyboard shortcuts will save you so much time when you're navigating around Evernote. It's really, really cool. I love the fact that I can go, in fact, let's go into my this week here. I'm going to remove the keyboard shortcuts. So I've got my this week here and I want to go back to my inbox. I just go command one, straight back to my my inbox. I'm going to go to command two, takes me to this week, my this week this week label. Command three takes me to, I can never remember these. What have I got in command two? But anyway, command three. Exercise. There we go. Exercise. I notice it comes up with exercise. Command three. Command four brings me to nothing. Command six. So go back to command one, go back to my inbox. So that's one of the ways that you can get through to your favorite. So whatever you've got set up for shortcuts, actually, there you go. I've only got three set up in my shortcuts in this particular thing. So it's number one, number two, number three. That's a really useful shortcut to have as well. So there you go. Well, thank you very much for watching this episode. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week.
Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.